Andean Condor versus California Condor. Who is stronger and would win in a fight? There are some big birds out there in the world. The largest living bird today is the ostrich, though it's obviously not a bird that can fly. But when you make a list of all the largest birds in the world, two that make the top 20 are the Andean Condor and the California Condor. In fact, among flighted birds, they both make the top 10. These are the only two species of condor in the world, and they're both enormous. But who's bigger? Who's stronger? If pitted against one another, who would win in a fight? We need to know, of the only two condor species, which is king? Big birds. When it comes to big birds, there's a few that come to your mind. We mentioned the world's largest, the ostrich. There's also cassowaries, emus, and rheas, none of which can fly. Now, when we think of large flying birds, there are swans and pelicans, and there's the wandering albatross with the largest wingspan of any living bird. And then, topping off the top 10 of largest flighted birds in the world, we see the Andean condor and the California condor. The condors are humongous birds that you'll often see looming from high above in an intimidating manner. They circle high above in a menacing way. There is a definite stigma attached to condors that make people fear them, that make people relate them to a bad omen. Some of this is myth. Then again, depending on who you are, you may have to beware the condor. They're not vegetarians, so someone will be looking up to the skies and seeing a condor, and they won't be too thrilled about it. Yes, condors are in fact carnivores. More specifically, they are scavengers. This means their diet comes from finding already deceased animals and making meals of them. Condors are New World vultures. Yes, there is also an image that you get when you think of a vulture, circling the sky slowly, waiting for a meal. That's why we get the same image when we think of a condor. Condors belong to the vulture family, but they are the two largest species in the vulture family. In fact, condors are the largest flying land birds in the entire Western Hemisphere. So we know they're humongous, we know they live in the West, we know they are scavengers. But if it's between an Andean condor and a California condor, who's winning the fight? Andean condor. Let's talk about the Andean condor first. As the name suggests, it is found in the Andes Mountains of South America. It can also be found on the Pacific coasts of South America, just west of the Andes. Not only is it found in several South American countries, it is also a national symbol of countries like Bolivia, Chile, Ecuador, Colombia, and Peru. The Andean condor is black with a ruff of white feathers on the neck and some white patches on the wings. The head is largely featherless and tends to be a dull red color, but get this, sometimes the coloring changes depending on the emotional state of the condor. Its face may flush if agitated when seeing other animals nearby. Interesting, like a living mood ring. Could that be an advantage or disadvantage if it had to do battle with the California condor? The Andean condor weighs on average 25 pounds. As we mentioned, it's a big bird. It is the third heaviest flying bird in the world. From beak to tail, the Andean condor's total length is between 3.3 to 4.3 feet. And the wingspan, it can be over 10 feet long. That means it has the second largest wingspan of any living bird behind the wandering albatross. A long wingspan like that means Andean condors can soar effortlessly for extremely long distances without expending too much energy. This is extremely helpful, as they will often travel 120 miles a day in search of food. Now, we mentioned the Andean condor is a scavenger, so when they're searching for food, they're searching for deceased animals. Whether killed recently or a while ago, they like to find a variety of deceased animals to feast on. They prefer larger animals such as llamas, guanacos, alpacas, deer, or rheas. But they'll also partake in armadillos, rabbits, and foxes. And as the introduction of people and farm animals has become more and more prevalent, they'll make meals of deceased cattle, goats, and other farm animals. And though they are primarily scavengers, they have been observed to do some hunting of smaller animals from time to time, usually just rodents, birds, or rabbits. Since they don't have powerful feet to grasp prey with as other birds of prey do, like the eagle or falcon, The Andean condor will kill its prey by repeatedly jabbing at it with its beak. And since they occasionally seek out live animals to hunt and kill, this makes them the largest bird of prey in the world. Again, most of the Andean condor's diet does come from already killed animals. When soaring through the air, they look for deceased animals on the ground. They also look for other circling scavengers or birds of prey to locate a kill, and they have a highly developed sense of smell, which can lead them to a meal as well. So that's the condor of South America. How about the condor of North America? California condor. Named after the state of California, those are just some of the stomping grounds of the California condor. It is also found in other southwestern regions of the United States, like in Arizona and Utah. They like to live in rocky shrublands, forests, and savannas, and will often be found near cliffs and large trees, as those are their preferences for nesting. The California condor is also mainly black. It has patches of white on the underside of its wings. The head is featherless, and in juveniles it will be gray in color, but in adults it will range between yellow and bright orange. The California condor weighs about 24 pounds on average, and from its beak to the tip of its tail, it's usually 3.6 to 4.6 feet long. Along with the impressive size of the body, the wingspan of the California condor is just over 9 feet long. Another instance of long wings, allowing this scavenger to soar through the sky effortlessly, scouring the grounds for meals. The California condor uses a lot of the same methods for finding food, as it is also a scavenger. It will fly impressive distances in one single day, sometimes as much as 160 miles. They will eat decayed carcasses, but much prefer fresh kills. A lot of the animals in North America vary from the animals in South America, but California condors have some favorites that are quite similar to those of the Andean condor. Common meals are deer, goats, sheep, donkeys, horses, cougars, bears, or pigs. If they find coyotes, rabbits, or squirrels, they'll take those as well. But the California condor does not find and kill live animals. It strictly is a scavenger. When searching for food, the California condor uses its vision to scout out possible meals and will also look for other birds that have spotted kills and flies to join them. It especially relies on this facet, such as spotting a turkey vulture that has found a carcass, because the turkey vulture will use its sense of smell to locate a dead animal. But the California condor has no sense of smell. It can't sniff out a meal, but it can find another animal that sniffed out a meal. Now that we've learned about each condor, let's close the borders. The Andean from South America, the Californian from North America. Should we have them meet in the middle? Does Central America work for everyone? Condor versus condor. We've brought the two together. It's almost time for the battle. Let's do some stat comparisons. The Andean condor weighs an average 25 pounds, and the California condor weighs on average 24 pounds. It isn't a humongous advantage, but the weight advantage does go to the Andean. 1 pound may not sound like a lot, but when it accounts for roughly 4% of their body weight, it can make a difference. The Andean condor ranges between 3.3 to 4.3 feet, while the California condor is between 3.6 to 4.6 feet. So with more length, the California condor may have swung the odds back in his favor. However, if we're looking at wingspan, the Andean condor's wingspan of over 10 feet beats the California condor's wingspan of over 9 feet. The wider wingspan allows for faster speeds and also longer distances to be able to be traveled with minimal effort. If either condor is pursuing the other, we have plenty of reason to believe the Andean will have more endurance. Scientists have even observed some Andean condors soaring 100 miles without flapping their wings once. And when we think of the two condors in the ways they get their food, the California condor does not even hunt, nor does it have a sense of smell. The Andean condor does occasionally hunt and has a great sense of smell. It's the little things. If one can sense the other one coming in an attack, They can defend themselves. It's easier to detect a threat when you have five senses instead of four. And the Andean condor has more experience with an attack, as it's used its beak to jab at prey before. That special skill could come in handy in a battle. Most signs point to the Andean condor being the victor most times these two would do battle. It's got the weight advantage. It's got better soaring speeds and flying abilities with those big wings. It has the sense of smell, and it has a better attack. It's got advantages all over the place. And though it could throw its weight around, let's not forget about the size advantage the California Condor has. That has to count for something. The California Condor may stand a chance as it has more length. Then again, the bigger they are, the harder they fall.